Subscribe the channel ProzTech and press the bell icon to get latest technology videos once we release. More importantly, the subscription to the channel is completely free. Friends, Galaxy S10e comes with Android 9.0 Pie and powered by Qualcomm Snapdragon 855 processor with 2.7 GHz octa-core with GPU Mali G76MP12. Whereas Oppo F7 runs Android 8.1 Oreo and powered by MediaTek Helio P60 processor with 2.0 GHz octa-core and GPU Mali G72MP3. If we see the display of the device, then you can find 5.8 inches screen size with Full HD Plus Dynamic AMOLED Infinity O display that comes with 2280 by 1080 pixels screen resolution with 438 ppi pixels density. This phone also comes with Corning Gorilla Glass 5 screen protection with Samsung Pay feature. This phone also comes with IP68 certified, that is dust or waterproof, up to 1.5 meters for 30 minutes. Whereas Oppo F7 is 6.23 inches device with Full HD Plus IPS LCD display having resolution 2280 by 1080 pixels and 405 ppi pixels density that comes with Corning Gorilla Glass 5 screen protection with speedy face unlock and AI recognition technology. Talking about the internal memory, then Galaxy S10e is available in two variants. One is 256GB with 8GB RAM and the other variant is 128GB with 6GB RAM and also supports microSD up to 512GB that uses SIM2 slot. Friends, as far as concerned about colors for this device, then it is produced in prism white, prism black, prism green, prism blue, canary yellow and flamingo pink colors. Moving on to Oppo F7, it is available in two variants. One is 64GB with 4GB RAM and other one is 128GB with 6GB RAM and also supports microSD up to 256GB with dedicated slot. Friends, as far as concerned about colors for this device, then it is produced in solar red, diamond black and moonlight silver. Friends, if we talk about the dimension of Samsung Galaxy S10e, it measures 142.2 by 69.9 by 7.9 mm of height, width and thickness, and it also comes with 150 grams of weight with hybrid dual nano SIM support. Whereas Oppo F7 measures 156 by 75.3 by 7.8 mm of height, width and thickness and 158 grams of weight with dual nano SIM option. About the camera, then Samsung Galaxy S10e comes with dual 12 plus 16 megapixels primary cameras with 1.5 to 2.4 wide angle aperture and 2.2 ultra wide aperture with dual pixel PDAF optical image stabilization, 0.5x out optical zoom up to 8x digital zoom. It shoot out 4K and full HD videos at 60 frames per second, while 720p HD at 30 frames per second with HDR, dual video recording and slow motion features. This phone is also equipped with 10 megapixels front camera with 1.9 wide angle aperture, dual pixel PDAF, live focus and with 4K and a full HD video at 30 frames per second recording. Moving on to primary camera of Oppo F7, it comes in 16 megapixels with a 1.8 aperture, face detection, autofocus and LED flash. You will also have geotagging, touch focus, face detection, HDR and panorama modes. It shoot out videos of 1080p at 30 frames per second and also equipped with 25 megapixels secondary front camera for taking selfie with 2.0 aperture and 1080p recording. Friends, in Galaxy S10e, fingerprint sensor is side mounted and the phone comes with different sensors like pressure sensor, hall sensor, accelerometer, gyro sensor, proximity, compass and barometer. This phone comes with Wi-Fi, dual band, Wi-Fi direct, hotspot, Bluetooth, GPS, NFC, Bixby, Type-C, reversible connector and fast battery charging with 15 watts. Furthermore, this phone supports fast wireless charger of 15 watts that is sold separately. This phone is powered by non-removable 3100 mAh battery as well. Whereas in Oppo F7, fingerprint scanner is placed on the back panel of the phone. It also comes with different sensors like magnetic induction, light sensor, accelerometer, proximity and gyro sensors. This phone comes with Wi-Fi Direct, Wi-Fi hotspot, dual band, GPS, Bluetooth, FM radio, micro USB 2.0 and USB on the go. This phone is also powered by a 3400 mAh non-removable battery as well. So that was the quick comparison of both smartphones. You can also check further details in the description below. What do you think about these smartphones? Do let us know in the comments section below. I hope you liked this video and don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe the channel. Thanks for watching.